Namibia has subscribed to the Sustainable Development Targets and other instruments that speak to access to information which promotes citizen participation in an effort to fight corruption and create good governance.
We sent out letters of information requests, just requesting for information as general members of public. We did not inform them that we were writing to them from the NMT or Action, because we wanted to have a study that is a representative of citizens or the general public of Namibia.
The assessment was carried out by looking at the management of public institutions' online platforms to assess their user-friendliness and the extent of information available. Out of the 10 public institutions evaluated in Namibia, some of them have an effective communication channel with the public, while others are helpless. The Ministry of Labor, Industrial Relations and Employment Creation received the Golden Key Award for being fast in the response. Their website was also found to be well managed with the latest and relevant content. The weakest golden padlock was given to the National Council of Namibia for being the most unresponsive institution that did not provide any information, not even acknowledging receipt of the information request. No recent information on their website, while they also do not interact with the public on their social media platforms.
And if a critical, a strategic institution such as the National Youth Council is this unresponsive to a researcher, what is the situation for your average Namibian youth out there in a rural area, for instance, who needs critical information that would really help them in their personal development?
Other ministries that did well include the Ministry of Information Communication Technology as well as Gender. In the context of COVID-19, the Ministry of Health has been commended for being transparent in the dissemination of COVID-19 related information. Timo Andreas, NBC News, Windhoek.